We're going to be talking about the federal mask mandate for a little while longer. Public transportation, federal masks, the mandate has been extended. Passengers on planes, trains, and other forms of transportation will be required to wear face coverings for at least 2 more weeks. That's through May 3rd. The measure was originally set to expire on Monday. Errol Barnett is at Reagan National Airport, just outside of Washington, D.C. Errol, good morning. What's the thinking here?
Hey there. Good morning, Tony. Look, this decision comes despite fierce and ongoing resistance from the airlines, the travel industry, and some Republican lawmakers as well. But it also means that air travelers are now experiencing 2 full years of having to mask up while traveling. Now, the spread of the recent BA2 subvariant of Omicron is why the CDC says this extension is needed, announcing in a statement that the move gives them time to assess the potential impact the rise of cases has on severe disease, including hospitalizations and deaths. Now, the spread of the subvariant has caused an uptick in reported cases since early April, driving outbreaks in the Northeast and parts of Florida. As we've been reporting, it now makes up more than 85% of all U.S. COVID infections. And this is now the 5th extension, and there are lawsuits filed in mostly Republican-led states seeking to overturn the federal mask requirement altogether. But we cannot exclude the American public here. A recent Harris poll in late March and early April found 60% of respondents are okay and support an extension of the mandate. And when we came here to Reagan National yesterday, speaking with travelers, they agree. So despite that ongoing resistance, most Americans are okay with masking up, at least for the moment, these next few weeks until we know more about this subvariant. Vlad?
All right, Errol, thank you very much.